I see people, people, yeah, 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 people. That's so weird, man. All of a sudden, there's people again, and we're on stage, and we're not spread out all across the whole continent, man. It is so wonderful to see you here. Thank you for being here. Yeah. Live music is best. Live, we got Pikachu here. That's cool. So glad to see everybody here. This is a couple things happening in this concert. First of all, that was Salt Peanuts, and that's one of the great, 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 great Dizzy Gillespie tunes, a bebop standard. And Dizzy Gillespie is a composer as much as he is as well known as a composer as he is as a trumpet player, for good reason, because he is an absolutely amazing composer and one of the seminal trumpet soloists in the history of jazz. But this is also an interesting juxtaposition of a couple different things, celebration of Dizzy Gillespie and National Hispanic History Month. It's National Hispanic, I've remembered this up until right now. Heritage. I remembered it until right now. National Hispanic Heritage Month. And you would, as I say that, it's probably you're thinking, huh, Dizzy Gillespie National Hispanic Heritage Month? How does that connect? Well, I'll tell you how. When we think about Latino music, Latinx culture, Hispanic music, particularly when it comes to jazz, we can think of a lot of different styles. We can think about mambo, we can think about cha-cha, we can think about rumba clave. We can think about guaguancos. We can think about, you can even talk about some sambas. You can think about bossa novas. Like I said, cha-cha. Lots of different things. Descargos. Lots of different styles. And in regard to jazz, a large reason that those styles are celebrated in jazz are because of the fortuitous meeting of two trumpet players, one from Havana, Cuba, named Mario Balsa, and the other one from Sherrill, South Carolina, named John Burks Dizzy Gillespie. And they met while they were both playing in different big bands in about 1939, and they became fast friends, and eventually they played together in the big band of, thank you very much, Cab Calloway. Heidi, 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 ho, Cab Calloway. Who said that back there? That's Dave. I was going to say, we got some hip parents. That's just Dave Powers, man. thought it was some hip parents out there. So they played together in Cab Calloway's band. And when they did that, they started to exchange some ideas. Actually, before they played in Cab Calloway's band, they started to exchange ideas. And so Mario Bauza started to take a lot of the bebop stuff that he heard Dizzy Gillespie do, and he incorporated it into his arrangements with Machito's orchestra, and Machito and the Afro-Cubans. And then Dizzy Gillespie started to incorporate a lot of the Afro-Cuban rhythms that he heard from Machito and from especially from Mario Bauza, and started to put that into his compositions and started to put that with his assorted big bands and different things like that. And all of a sudden, you get this thing called Latin jazz, which is largely the result of those two guys meeting. When we talk about Hispanic Latin jazz, when we talk about all those different kinds of Latin jazz things, there is a disparate, lots of different kinds of styles from a lot of different regions. But they have three things in common. They have the African culture, which is a part of the slave trade. They have the indigenous folk cultures for whatever region they happen to be from. And they have the European culture from whichever imperialist society was dominant in that specific area. Think about Brazil, and you can think about the Portuguese influence in Brazilian music, but also you can think about the indigenous, all the different indigenous cultures, and you can think about the African cultures that landed there because of the slave trade. So those are things they all have in common. And you're going to hear a lot of Afro-Cuban kind of percussion, a lot of Latin percussion, a lot of different things like that. By the way, that featured, before I forget, that tune featured Mike Foley on trombone. And Drew Powell on piano. As well as one of the Andrews. We got two Andrews, and the Andrew that you heard from in the percussion section that time is Andrew Tice. You'll hear Andrew Haynes do his things in a bit, so you're gonna hear from both Andrews. This next tune is a Dizzy Gillespie tune that he wrote for Woody Herman. He did some arrangements for Woody Herman's Thundering Herd, and this is one of those tunes. And it's called Woody and You. Woody and You, Woody and You, Woody and You. And this is going to feature Connor Kennedy on tenor sax. And who else? That's it. Connor just took all the solos. Woody and You. Thank you. Gillespie. I should have mentioned, this is dance music, and there is a big dance floor here, so you are welcome to dance if you like. I'm just saying, if you want to, there's nothing stopping you from dancing. Sarah, you want to dance? No, Sarah doesn't. All right, here we go. The next tune, that was a nice little wah-wah co-groove, nice 3-2 clave, 2-3 clave, in a wah-wah co-groove. This next tune is gonna be a rumba clave, and it's gonna feature, who's it gonna feature? Clay Kessler on trumpet. The Clay Kessler fan club is right here, man. If you want to join, you can get, they have some cards and all that. It's going to feature Clay. This is interesting tune. This is one of Dizzy Gillespie's most famous tunes. He has a lot of famous tunes, but this one is one of the most famous. This is a tune called A Night in Tunisia. Now, it's interesting because when you listen to it, you think, wow, Dizzy was influenced. When you hear it, you think, wow, man, Tunisia must have made a big influence on him. When he wrote the tune, he had been nowhere near Tunisia. The tune was actually called Interlude, and he called it Interlude, and that's what it's sometimes still known as. Someone else said, you should call this A Night in Tunisia. So Dizzy was like, okay, fine, it's A Night in Tunisia. That's how glib he was about it. But it's one of his most famous tunes. This is A Night in Tunisia. Thank you. Clay Kessler on trumpet. David York on trombone. And Connor Kennedy, who you heard from already, on tenor sax. Thank you so much. By the way, we were gonna play another tune. We were gonna play five tunes, and we decided we were gonna save that other tune for you. We could play it. You know, let's go ahead and play it. You guys wanna play it?
Yes.
Shall we do it?
Yes.
No, I'm seeing too many people go, no. So we'll save it for the next concert. We'll save that. That's Groovin High. We'll save that for the next concert. It was a special tune just for you, but we decided we'd make you wait. Plus, we weren't quite ready to play it tonight. So that's another thing altogether. So want to introduce the members of the band. Connor Kennedy on tenor sax.
Woo! Yeah.
Tito Leong on alto sax. Quentin Gopal on the alto sax. Izaiah Steenrod on the tenor sax. Joel Caniff on bari sax. Michael Herring on trombone back there. Jacob Smith on trombone. Looked like a trumpet there for a second. Mike Foley on trombone. David York on trombone. Clay Kessler on trumpet. Elizabeth Lewis on trumpet. Her fan club is bigger than yours, so just keep taking note. Will Gilicinski on trumpet. Carter Steven on trumpet. now we're just going, okay. By the way, Carter Steven is my band grandson. I was his dad's band director in the 80s in Illinois. So he's my band grandson. How about that? Drew Powell on piano. Grant Jones on guitar. Tristan Collins on bass. And a pair of Andrews. Andrew Haynes on drums and percussion right there. And Andrew Tice on drums and percussion over there. Just so you know, the tune that we cut was one that Andrew Haynes plays on. He's going to play a lot more drum set next concert. I cut one of his tunes. As a matter of fact, maybe I cut two of his tunes. Not because of him, but that's just the way it fell. But they're going to be alternating back and forth. And so actually, they're going to be both featured on the next tune. Speaking of the next tune, before I forget, stick around. That next concert is going to be great with Dr. Wallace and the Jazz Ensemble. If you are a person here for these folks, please stay and listen to the entire concert if you can. I know sometimes people get busy, but if you can stay and listen to the whole concert, we'd appreciate it because they need some love too. So, and applause, and they're going to be wonderful. So, what else? Oh, we have a concert coming up in November. What is it, November 15th? Is that right? What is it? 16th, November 16th. Thank you. Our esteemed graduate assistant, Jeremy Smith back there, keeps all of our dates. November 16th. While I'm at it, so some introducing folks. Tim Donald and his crew do an amazing job. Tim Donald back there and the crew. The crew is all around here. They do wonderful things for us. This last tune is called Manteca. This is a tune written by Dizzy Gillespie, his longtime arranger friend, Walter Gil Fuller, who did a lot of arrangements for him, and a guy named Luciano Pozo y Gonzalez, also known as Chano Pozo, And Chano Pozo was introduced to Dizzy Gillespie in about 1945, 1946. And Dizzy Gillespie was looking for a great, great percussionist to put into his band in the future. And he found this guy through Mario Balsar named Chano Pozo. And Chano Pozo was this amazing cunguero. Cunguero being a person who plays cungas and bongos, cungos, and all different kinds of things. And he was steeped in Santeria traditions and the music, Yoruban music from Cuba. And so he taught Dizzy a lot of the different rhythms, a lot of the cool things that come out of the Afro-Cuban tradition and the Santeria religious tradition. And he brought that to the band. And he played with Dizzy, and there was a famous concert, 1947, 48, in Carnegie Hall, and Chano Pozo was there. And tragically, not very long after that, December 1948, Chano Pozo was killed, very young. He was shot and killed. But he had a very, very long-lasting effect on Dizzy Gillespie. And this is one of the tunes that he wrote with Dizzy. This is Manteca, Manteca, which means lard, grease, lard, whatever you want to think of. But it's one of those Dizzy Gillespie tunes that is just, it just gets you can't help but groove. You just can't help it. We're going to do a version of this tune that's going to incorporate some nice Cuban Afro-Latin percussion from Andrew Haynes. Special guest timbalero named Miguel Puente, who's going to come up and play. No, it's me. It's not his name. And Andrew Tice on drum set. This is Manteca. Thank you. Thank you for being here. Thank you so much. Thank you. Come to more concerts. We have concerts on the website all the time. Come to all the concerts. There's a world of great, amazing music here at OSU. We have so many fine ensembles. Please, there's some concert band concerts next week. All kind of choral groups, orchestra, all kinds of wonderful stuff. The choirs are getting a chance to sing again. Please, please come back to as many concerts, recitals as you can. So says Eugenia Costa Giomi, who wants you to be at all of the concerts. Is that correct? Our fine director of the School of Music, Dr. Costa Giomi. How about a hand for her, please? Thank you very much. Yaz Ensemble will be on in just a second.
Thank you. Thank you, thank you. We are the Ohio State University Jazz Ensemble. First, let's have a hand again for the lab, the Jazz Lab Band under the direction of Professor Mike Smith. With everything going on in this country, it was important to me to focus on the music of Black American men. Though a season of protesting was the aftermath of yet another slain Black man by the hands of white police officers, not much has been done to highlight, support, and celebrate Black men and boys. So, last year, the Jazz Ensemble focused on the music of the Count Basie Orchestra. This year, we are focusing on John Clayton. John is a virtuoso composer, arranger that writes in a style heavily influenced by the Count Basie Orchestra, and this for good reason. He was a member of the band where he served as the bassist and one of the arrangers. My relationship started with John Clayton at a moment during the Gulf War when Whitney Houston sang a memorable rendition of the Star Spangled Banner at the 1991 Super Bowl. I didn't know it then, but John Clayton was the arranger. Then when I was working on my undergraduate degree at Western Michigan University, John was a guest composer and arranger and conductor. When I moved to Columbus, Ohio in 2004, for the job I now occupy, I began performing in the Columbus Jazz Orchestra, and because of the sheer magnitude of John's artistic brilliance, he has been a guest of the CJO several times. One of the most memorable and notable moments was a few years ago when Benny Green, Jeff Hamilton, and John Clayton were all featured with the CJO, and through the efforts of Jim Rupp and the Jazz Arts Group, the Ohio State University was able to host a masterclass with Benny, Jeff, and John. Hughes 109 was packed, and the students were totally mesmerized by one of the best masterclasses I've witnessed. I've also had the distinct pleasure of interviewing John for my Conversations with Dr. Thunder interview series on my YouTube channel. Shameless plug there. So a few words about John. Clayton began studying double bass at age 16 with Ray Brown. 3 years later, he was bassist of the Henry Mancini's television series, The Mancini Generation, in 1975. He graduated from Indiana University. He went on to tour with Monty Alexander Trio and the Count Basie Orchestra before taking the position of principal bass in the Amsterdam Philharmonic Orchestra in Amsterdam, Netherlands. After 5 years, he returned to the U.S. for a break from the classical genre, and in 1985, co-founded the Clayton Hamilton Jazz Orchestra with his brother, saxophonist Jeff Clayton, rest in peace, and drummer Jeff Hamilton. He also performed in a duo as the Clayton Brothers with musicians such as Bill Cunliffe and Terrell Stafford. He has been artistic director for the Lionel Hampton Jazz Festival, Sarasota Jazz Festival, Santa Fe Jazz Party, Jazz Port Townsend Summer Workshop, Jazz at Centrum. There's hundreds, thousands. His discography is ridiculous. So he's composed and arranged for the Count Basie Orchestra, Diana Krall, Whitney Houston, Carmen McRae, Nancy Wilson, Joe Williams, Ernestine Anderson, Quincy Jones, Dee Dee Bridgewater, Natalie Cole, Till Brunner, and the Tonight Show Band. And to top it off, he's a tremendous father. In 2006, his son, Gerald Clayton, came in second at the Thelonious Monk International Jazz Piano Competition. So we're going to continue on with some more John Clayton music. Thank you. Thank you. All right. So I want to let you know who these fine folks behind me are. And I'm not a small person, so maybe I should stand a little bit to the side. On alto saxophone, Will Fagel. Grayson Holloway. On tenor saxophone, Jared Shackelford. And Ben Sim. On baritone saxophone, Benjamin Consker. On trombone, Jay Sandlin. Parker Lewis, Levi Steenrod, and Cole Roller. On trumpet, Ivan Murray. Miles Smith. Kaylin Quigley. Ethan Kavanaugh. On piano, Nathan Snyder. Yeah. On guitar, Victor Madeline. All right. On bass, Connor Nichols. So one of our drummers, and we're thinking about you, buddy, Jake Quadrino, he had a death in the family, and so he had to, he couldn't be here. So our thoughts and prayers are with him. Our other drummer, Auden Stevenson. All right, more music. So the first two tunes, see here, first one was called 15 Minutes Late. Second tune was Bag's Groove. We're gonna continue on with Brush This. One. Thank you, thank you. That was John's arrangement of Duke Ellington's Come Sunday.
Thank you.
Thank you. That was called Blues for Stephanie. Now it is time to bring our guests out. So I wanted to talk a little bit about them. So Dr. Milton Ruffin. Milton Von Ruffin holds a BM in Jazz Studies and BME, MA, and PhD degrees in music education from The Ohio State University. He has been employed by Columbus City Schools for 31 years, currently a principal and director of the Fort Hays Metropolitan Education Center. Dr. Ruffin was the 2019 recipient of the Ohio State University School of Music Distinguished Alumnus Award and a 2019 inductee to the Ohio Jazz Music Hall of Fame. Under Dr. Ruffin's leadership, Fort Hays has been designated as a school of promise by the state of Ohio and identified as one of the top 100 high schools in America by U.S. News and World Report. Additionally, the school was chosen by President Barack Obama to introduce the Jobs Act. Fort Hays is a member of the prestigious Berkeley City Music Network and has been awarded a Grammy Award as a Grammy Signature School 2011 to 2012, and Ruffin has co-written the song Wait with his daughter, Dr. Neil Allen, achieving number one status on Billboard's gospel airplay charts. He's the minister of music of New Salem Missionary Baptist Church. I worked at that church when I met my wife, and he had something to do with that. So I'll be grateful for that forever. Anyhow, Dr. Milton Ruffin, where is he at? There he is. Have a hand for him. And Dr. Robert Brooks. Dr. Robert Brooks is a jazz saxophonist and educator dedicated to cultivating the tradition of jazz education. He holds a DMA and MM from the University of Illinois, Urbana-Champaign, and a BM from Central Michigan University. I grew up in Michigan too, that's okay. he currently serves as associated faculty in jazz studies at Ohio State. Robert's most recent releases, Accidental Nomad and New Standard Duo on Rope-A-Dope Records, have received critical acclaim. He has toured with Reginald Chapman's Pressure Fit, Sun Stereo, and The Lake Effect throughout the Midwest and East Coast. He has also performed with jazz legends, including Bob Mincer, Bobby Shue, Tom Bones Malone, Jeff Hamilton Trio, Jim Pugh, Joel Spencer, Tito Carrillo, Nathan Gunn, The Temptations, and many more. Dr. Robert Brooks. There he is. So this will be our last selection of the evening. Thank you for sticking around. And let's see, Jazz Ensemble has a concert on November 12th. And then the combo. Yes, yes, yes. All right, so I'm supposed to say those things. So anyhow. This is Soup Bone, and this is composed by John Clayton. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Enjoy your evening.